tunnels. So are you suggesting that the Undercity's cavern reaches that deep? Into the City of Floods?
Into what is left of it. All we need to do is find an entrance point that can lead us down.
Then we leave without further delay. There's no point in leading an army down there, so the four of us will go alone. Prophetess, speak to the Archmagister and tell him to give you the Word of the Dead and the container for the Nominos. We will need both. He's at the beacon.
Shouldn't we at least think this through before we go? We...
Ready your equipment. We'll meet at the gate to the Undercity.
Okay. You going there too?
The heart of the Pyrian Empire right below our feet. Unbelievable. You should go and talk to the Archmagister. I'll wait for you at the Undercity.
Alright, be careful then.
Is it important?
This is very important.
Prophetess.
Alright. So we're really at a point of no return? What if I try to leave this area? Just curious. Maybe we're not actually at the point of no return yet. One way to test that theory out.
Thy name is my sacrament.
You cannot fast travel right now.
Malphas's blessing.
It's locked. Haha. Just wanted to see for myself. They were not kidding. After all this, we still need to get the Numinos for this thing. Now, I have some... theories. By now, by the time you watch this, I should have finished the game. So I guess there's no... I don't have to worry about you guys being... inadvertently encouraged to post spoilers, but I have some theories. Number one is, well, I am not from this eventuality. I'm from another eventuality. And I lived in a previous civilization. Could be Pyrian, could be another civilization even before that. And that's what the dreams I'm seeing about Father and all that stuff is from my life in another civilization. And somehow I crossed an eventuality into this eventuality. Not sure. The other thing is that I could be a high one. And I absorbed that entire civilization. That's why I have memories of these people, of that kid, the father, the family that he was abusive and they burned them and all this stuff. That's a memory that I have of that civilization because I'm a high one and I absorbed all their essences. But for some reason, I don't know I'm a high one, I lost my memory or something like that. And that's generally where I'm going with that. It's either one or the other. I was from that civilization. Maybe I escaped being absorbed by a high one. Or crossed into another eventuality where... Wait, what does that? I crossed into this eventuality. Something to that effect. Although you'd think if I did cross into an eventuality where that civilization was never destroyed, wouldn't still be around today? Or maybe Maybe I'm a high one, reliving the memories of this civilization, and this civilization has already been destroyed. That's another thing. But then what's the deal with Daddy and all that? So I'm not sure where this is going, but I think it's something like that. I'm supposed to talk to a novice? Supposed to meet Magister Mariel.
Oh, aren't you... never mind.
A high one? I don't know.
How can I help you?
Trying to figure that out. I'm looking for the Archmagister. I was told he's here.
He was. But he went to get something. Why don't you wait until he comes back? I have to admit that it's a great honor to finally meet you in person.
Really?
You know, when all this started, when the Grand Master exalted you, I thought it was a sin. Granting an outlander what we have to fight so hard for.
Yeah, I know.
But now... Phew! I think Malthus, or whoever sent you that he did... We owe you a lot. Really.
Thank you. I'm just starting to wonder if you really do owe me anything, actually.
Oh, don't thank me. Say... May I ask you something?
You just did. Okay, what?
It. The beacon. Do you really think it'll work? I mean, I'm just a novice, but... If it can really banish the High Ones, how come the Pyreans couldn't save themselves?
I don't know.
I just don't understand.
Me neither. I mean, they have to see what we're doing. They're pretty knowledgeable of all these different civilizations, including our own. You'd think they know that we have this thing set up here. And they're not doing anything about it. I think it's in their power to do something about it. So, the fact that they're not doing anything about it means that it's no threat to them. But, yeah. Honestly, the summary of that is me neither, but I don't think we have any other options.
You know, I lost someone not too long ago. It was the Nehrimese, under the command of that butcher Korik. My family has a small farm near the coast. And when the first of the Nehrimese ships landed, I immediately rowed to them to get them into the city. Into safety.
Guessing that didn't end up well? And, well, what happened?
I'm sorry. This isn't easy.
It's alright.
Our farm. It's on a small cliff near the Farmer's Coast. Just a few miles from Ark. I already had a bad feeling when I set out. And then I saw the smoke. And then there was that... smell. And...
That smell. I'm thinking burning flesh.
The smell of burnt meat.
Yeah.
It was everywhere. I rode faster and faster, and then when I got to the house, I saw that it was on fire. And that someone had put up three crosses. And they were burning too. My mother, my father, and my sister, they were still alive, you know? And I just stood there, and there was nothing I could do. Do you understand? Nothing. And it doesn't matter how I try to look at it. It all amounts to one thing. I was too weak. I was too late, and I was too weak.
Yeah.
That wouldn't have happened to you, would it? You would have done something. You would have saved them. Just as you'll save us.
I wouldn't put that much faith in me.
If I could just be more like you, then I... Your flesh.
What?
Yes, that's it. All I need is a piece of your flesh. And nothing like that will ever happen again.
I don't want to give you that. Just stay where you are. Don't come any closer.
But why?
Because
it's so hard to understand.
Don't like you that much right now.
I don't want much. Just a small piece of it.
Oh, good God.
You just don't want to share. Isn't that it?
What's the...
You want it all for yourself. Because you're vain.
I'm vain.
With all your damn vanity. You don't even see the futility of the whole thing.
Okay, red madness.
The beacon
red madness.
It never will. Thousands have tried it before you. Thousands who are as arrogant as you are. And they all failed.
Well, you changed Europe.
How did they say? Just let yourself fall.
What? Keeper. Don't say that.
Prophetess.
Oh my god. Whoa! Alright, I'm not liking you people right now.
We need to
Yeeksh! I guess I can't leave from there. I can't. I was not expecting this at all. Fight back on them! What's he doing? Oh, Archmagister's fighting? Oh my god. Wait, no. I'm not doing much. I can't get away from these people. Oh my god! My arcane fever worsened from 4% to 4%. What? Where's my guy? Oh, I'm not summoning her. Alright, that... No kidding. This doesn't work at all? Alright. Ow! No more kid gloves. He's not fighting this guy. He's not registering them as enemies. Boots of the Keeper. Oh, this is like equal to Lorem's cuirass, otherwise I'd grab it. Can I wear that? Vambrace's hands. He has gauntlets, which is the same as... Well, that worked better off.
Name of the sun. They were possessed. But how is that possible? I thought the sigil stone protects us.
Obviously doesn't. Maybe they've... Over. Who's sighing? Maybe they've, it's so strong now that it overtakes the effects of the sigil stones. So what about the beacon? How badly is it damaged?
Oh, of course. Wait.
Okay. Not only was the beacon damaged, but the game crashed. So that's how badly the damage they did.
Oh, of course. Wait.
To search for Ben. Oh, I think I hit rest or something. Or T. Didn't mean to do that. Am I... This is before I took the cheese. So let's take the cheese. Oh, here you are.
Acceptable. Nothing we shouldn't be able to repair. But wait, what is that noise?
What? What noise? Oh, armies?
Oh, by the righteous pan. I think you should see this.
I hear people yelling.
What in blazes happened here? And what is that noise?
What that?
They are in the city. Their entire army.
Yeah, you hear that.
What?
I want to see something. Can I wear this? That's like a cape.
No. This is impossible. This is impossible! And this? What's the meaning?
I don't think it goes with what I have.
This bloodbath.
I don't know, Grandmaster. The High Ones somehow were able to possess the Keepers.
Well,
trying to destroy the beacon.
Can't see anything.
Kill the prodigy.
What? But the stone, we...
Grandmaster, you have to see this.
What? That the Nehrimese are in the city? I know that already.
I think she means something else.
No, we know how they did it. The true Chesar betrayed us.
Oh, wonderful.
Nonsense.
It's the truth. She and almost a third of the Keepers followed Bartar's example.
I believe it.
Come, you should hear it for yourself.
Witness the traitor's interrogation. The city of 1,000 floods is underneath Ark. To get there, we need to travel through the tunnels of the Undercity until we find a breach which leads to the lower cavern. This is at least a theory. Grandmaster Aranthiel wants me to get the word of the dead from Ark Magister Mariel. Well, we're a little busy right now with other things, I guess.
I ordered that the temple gates be closed right away and positioned archers on the battlements.
Good idea.
At least for now, none of these Nehrimese bastards will enter the temple.
Well done.
Well, you're gonna show us something down here? Keeper robe. Is it down there or not? Right, I'm going here. Hopefully you guys will come with me. Oh, Kalia's here.
There. She survived it. Open your eyes, traitor.
What? Hi, Grandmaster. I am so sorry. It shouldn't have happened like that. Oh, my Malthus. What have I done?
Tell us what happened.
Of course, Grandmaster. I will. The Trichessa. She contacted Korak and asked for...
Relax. She's bleeding to death, Grandmaster. We need to get him to the curarium.
We will, once we're done. Continue. The Chuchessa arranged a meeting with Korek. What did she want from him?
A truce. She offered him the city. If he would promise not to harm anyone.
That's the promise made.
She had this stone. You know, the sigil stone that protects us keepers from the high ones. Korek.
Yeah.
He agreed.
I guess he immediately started harming people.
Once the gates were open, he
killed everyone.
Yes.
An idiot.
The Trichessa. Even though she kept her end of the bargain. Then they swarmed into the city and... Oh, but Malphus, I am so sorry. I'm so sorry.
She's a traitor and
take
an idiot.
Yes. Yes, of course, Grandmaster. Lerum, Yetta, bring me a stretcher.
Wait. You have to forgive me. We only wanted the best. You have to believe me. Please don't let me die as a pathless. Please.
I forgive you. Now go.
Better man than I
yes.
am.
Yes, of course, Grandmaster.
Hey, don't you
what are your orders,
bashing her like that?
We aren't many, but if we use cunning, we might be able to drive them back out of...
We will not. We are no more than 5 dozen up here, and the Nehrimese are thousands. And both our black powder and our boiling oil are in the barracks.
Then it's over. We've lost.
What? No! Nothing is over! They can't be that far into the city yet. We only have to drive them out of the gates, and then...
And how exactly are you planning to do that? By loading the cannons with sugar mint and shooting balls of herbs at the Nehrimese? Great idea, really.
You sodding!
Quiet! Narajil and Sharim are right, Commander.
You're sort of way.
Ark is lost. But our war against the High Ones isn't. The beacon still stands and it will continue to do so as long as we hold the temple. We've lost the battle, yes. But not the war. All we need is the Numinas, and then the beacon will be lit.
And what then? I don't think Korek will withdraw once we've destroyed his vision of this ascent.
Correct, he won't. Which is why we will surrender.
What?
It is the only way. As I said to the Chuchessa before, this war is about more than just us. If we choose to give up now, or if we choose to fight and die down there, Korek will destroy the beacon either way and let the cleansing happen. We will prevent that at all costs. Which is why we will find the Numinas, light the beacon, and then surrender.
But Korek will kill us all.
Yes, he will. We will die, but there is no alternative. Korek isn't man enough to participate in the battle himself. So even if he were to break out and fight, all we would do is kill his delusional soldiers. And their deaths would be as pointless as this entire war. Once the High Ones are vanquished, we've done our duty. That's it.
But no! We are warriors, and true warriors fight! You've said
true
that!
True warriors ask questions. Like the question... When does a battle for ideals become nothing more than a battle for vanity? Those soldiers down there, Commander, they are nothing more than butchers. But we are more than that.
So you want to save their lives?
I will not stop you. As soon as the beacon is lit, you're free to flee. But for now, you will hold this place at all costs while we search for the Numinas. Archmagister, do you have the word of the dead?
I do, yes. But how do you plan to get into the Undercity from here? The entire city is swarming with Korax's soldiers.
Leave that to me. Commander Eren, gather the remaining Keepers and Arcanists. I will address them.
Probably just teleport there. That's what we do, teleport places. Now what? Attend Telaranthir's speech. I get the feeling I should be doing something. Oh, you're gonna come over here and make a speech. Well then, get over here.
You all know what has happened. We were betrayed by our own brothers and sisters. As we speak, people are dying. Slaughtered by the Nehrimese, who think we are their enemy.
They can't hear you from here.
And I know what you are feeling right now. Anger. Anger aimed at those in our ranks who did this to
us. Come over here, guys.
But you're wrong. Despite their deed, they wanted to protect us, to fulfill their holy duty. And the same applies to Koarek and his soldiers. Yes, they are deluded. Yes, they have committed crimes past redemption, but they, too, only did what they thought was right. If there is someone to blame in all this, it's the High Ones and no one else. They, brothers and sisters, they are the ones responsible. They have no mind, no compassion, no soul, and their only reason for existing is to destroy. They are cowards who act out of the shadows and play us against each other like puppets on strings. And right now, they think they have won. They think they can defeat us. But they will fail. Because we are still here.
I'll relay your words to
them. We have the beacon. The only thing capable of stopping all this madness. And that is exactly what we're going to do. After that, you are free to go. Flee, fight. Do whatever you think is best. I myself will surrender. Because every drop of blood spilled after we have done our duty and destroyed the High Ones is useless. And even if the Nehrimese kill me, my death will be a sign. A sign that people like Koarek will never understand. Hatred breeds hatred.
True.
This is what history has taught us. And this is what makes the High Ones strong. Stand by me when the time comes. Or go. But until then, fight.
You guys heard that? Right, well, hopefully he's really gonna go to the tower room and not just keep standing there.
Follow me. We will talk in the Emporium.
Okay. Where did Kalia go? Leah disappeared again. Not walking up here, is she?
I can't believe Sigil Berabartar betrayed us, not him.
I can't believe the other lady. Well, yeah, I can't believe she betrayed us, actually. Trichessa. We'll have her head on a pike. Or a spike. Where? Grandmaster rooms? I think I have to go this way? No. Okay.
Prophetess.
Yeah. Basement. Oh, there's stairs here. telling me this way. Ah. It's a pretty good trick throwing your voice like that.
And there she goes. 4,000 years this city has stood. And now she is aflame. It is a tragedy.
Those brutes. You told the others that we're going to find the Numenos, but how? How are you planning to get into the Undercity with the Nehrimese in the streets?
There is another way. I suppose you already know that the Order was never proud of the fact that something like the Undercity exists. And due to your dealings with the Relata, you also know that we, the Order, had an informal agreement with them.
Yeah, I could teleport down there.
They rule the underground and we rule the surface. In reality, however, this is only half the truth. We never handed over the reins entirely. There is a plan B in case things get out of control and the Undercity's inhabitants revolt, like they did once during the Blood Moon riots.
A plan B. I have an idea what that might mean.
Probably. I will make it short. There's a set of tunnels throughout the King's Mountain on which this temple was built, and they lead all the way down into the Undercity. They were built to release poison gas into the entire cave system.
Oh my god. In other words, if the Undercity were to have revolted again, you would have simply killed them all with poison gas.
It would have been an option. With the gates to the surface barred, no one would have survived.
Damn. So let me guess, your plan is to use these tunnels to sneak down to the Undercity, obviously.
Down and back up again, yes. The Nehrimese do not know about these tunnels, and when they find out, it will be too late. We descend, we find the Numenos in the City of Floods, and we light the beacon. After that, you know what I will do. There is a way into the tunnels through the dungeons of this temple. Meet me and Sharim there once you're ready to depart. And bring your beloved with you.
Okay,
prepare yourself. We will meet in the dungeon.
For the greater good, completed. The Shards of Order, Part 1. Meet Kalia in the Sun Temple. The worst case happened. The Truchessa and around half of the remaining keepers betrayed us. They left Taranor Korak's armies into the city, an event which they rewarded in blood. Now everything is up to us. Solely the Sun Temple isn't raided by the Nehrimese yet, and we have to find a way to search for the Numenos and ignite the beacon before it is too late. And this says most of that. According to Aranthiel, there is some sort of shaft system linking the Sun Temple with the Undercity. Ironic. Originally, this system would have been used to kill an angry mob if a riot occurred. Now it will be the key to salvation.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm going to meet her somewhere out here.
Malfas's blessings.
Thank you.
Prophetess, we will do what we can here, but hurry. Who knows what the Nehrimese will come up with to get inside.
I will. She's over there. Let me call it an episode here. We will commence the Shards of Order Part 1. We'll talk with Kalia, and we'll do our best to get down into these tunnels. It's going to be fascinating.
Prophetess, we will do what we can here, but hurry. Who knows what the Nehrimese will come up with to get inside.
I've heard that. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.